स्कैटर डायग्राम चैप्टर नंबर 16. दिस इज न्यू टॉपिक एंड इट इज़ नथिंग डिफरेंट बट द प्लॉटिंग ऑफ द ग्राफ बट इन अ डिफरेंट वे. वी टेक टू वेरिएबल हेयर एंड दे आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन ईच अदर. सो वन वी टेक हॉरिजॉन्टल एक्सिस एंड अदर इज वी टेक ऑन वर्टिकल एक्सिस. हेयर इट इज वर्टिकल एक्सिस. सो टू एक्सिस आर देयर, एक्स एंड वाई, एंड बोथ आर this is independent value we take, and it is dependent value we take, so that we can visualize the information quite easily. So let's see what is the purpose of sketching this diagram. Scatter diagram is used when we want to show the correlation that exists between the two set of data mean two variable, one is horizontal and other is on vertical. We use a scatter diagram when there is too much information, where we cannot afford enough time for the bar chart. To make a bar chart is quite difficult task and it consume time. But scatter diagram is quite easy, and it is quite easy to take the information from this scatter diagram. So that is why we prefer a scatter diagram over the bar graph. Let's see what we do in scatter diagram. By looking at the scatter diagram, plotting of a scatter diagram is easy. Okay, plotting of a scatter diagram is just look like this, and it is these value is our x and y axis value, or horizontal and vertical value, just like a coordinates. This is the coordinates, x or y coordinate. So we plot the coordinates after taking the information, and then we analyze what sort of a scatter diagram this is. So let's see type of correlation. Actually, it is correlation. This is the correlation of two variable. So a positive correlation means when the value of one set of data increases, the other data is also increased. Suppose this is the time and this is the distance. So when the time is increased, the distance is also increased. So it is one thing is increasing, so other is also increasing. So this is called the positive correlation. And the real life, for example, the more the rain is there, so number of size of puddling is there. Or when the rain is there, number of water is stuck different where. So it makes the place. So this is called the positive correlation. And when the time or the other thing is increasing, one thing is increasing, other thing is decreasing, it is called negative correlation. When the value of one set of data is increased, the other data is decreased. This is called negative correlation. A real life is the watch is in use, the less energy is left in the battery. Or more the we watch the movie on the mobile, less the battery is left. Quite easy example. So the next diagram, when there is no data can be analyzed as a positive correlation or the negative correlation. So it is there may be two set of data that has no correlation in the relationship. The value of one set of data has neither positive nor negative effect on the other set. So no data is depend on other data. A real life example is the amount of water we drink has no relationship with the amount of homework we would like to do. So these two variable has no relation, so it is called no correlation, and the graph is plot like this. So this is all about this topic, and we will inshallah try to solve the question related to the chapter, then it will be more clear to you.